Father's Day is coming up, but to me, it's just another day. See, my dad, he never loved me, but I know my Abba always has. It just doesn't make it right to me, and it really doesn't make it fair. I spent my whole life waiting for my dad to love me, but still, he was never there. I looked for love in places it could never be found. I cried and wondered why. If I couldn't get my dad to love me, how could I be loved by another guy? Then some years ago, my dad, he died. And I thought, man, I'll never know why it is he didn't want me, why when I needed him, he didn't show. I needed to know what was wrong with me for him to tell me how I'm flawed, so I can do my best to fix it and my life, it can finally move on. My dad's gone now, and I never figured it out, why I was so unworthy of love. So I bowed my head and cried my tears, and one foot in front of the other, I kept going. My journey's led me to a place I never thought I'd be. I left my home and all that I knew, hoping I could start again. But my past was haunting, and the tears still came. I just never understood. How could you bring someone into this cruel world's life and not love them enough to walk them through it? Then one day, in the most unlikely place, I sat and heard a story told. See, I knew of this man, and I knew he died, but he died for even the worst of those. He loved me because he could love anything, which didn't make me special at all. But this story I heard was of a different kind, and of a love I never knew. A love that said, these aren't just rules, but don't do these things because I love you. This story didn't tell of a time in life where greener pastures would make it all right. It didn't have me think that if I just bide my time, the famous good life would soon be mine. But in this story, and man was it old, I heard something my heart needed to know. I heard of those rules that I found so hard to keep, that they were there to help keep me from harm, and there to help keep me safe. They were there to make sure I didn't hurt those that I love, or cause the already broken to just crumble and fall. Now I know you've heard all that I've said, and you're tired. You listen well, but don't give up now. Come on, stay with me. I've got just a little more to tell. Now in this story, I was seen as something I never thought I'd be. Fearfully and wonderfully made? Yeah, right. So is every other ugly living thing. What I needed was my father's love. Or so I thought, before the story helped me see. If someone saw me as a bride. But wait, isn't a bride a beautiful thing? Brides are so lovely the way they just glow. And when that mate looks at them, it's like there's no one else he'd rather know. He looks at her with eyes that say he wants her always to be his. And when they're standing side by side, it's like no other care exists. A groom would do anything to protect his wife. He'd even give his very life. He would lavish her with all of himself. A groom really does love his wife. Now as I sat and listened, I struggled hard to see how the girl in this story could ever really be me. How could someone love me? See me with that kind of love, when my own father didn't even know who I was. Then it hit me. Did you see? My father, he really didn't know me. He left before he could find out who I was. So maybe it really wasn't me he didn't love. But there was someone, the one of whom the story told, and I've been on his mind since a long, long time ago. He knew everything about me. All my hopes, all my fears, every quirk, fall, and flaw, yet he still wanted me to be his. And as far as the story, as I listened, it helped me understand that greener pastures wasn't the good life or the promised land, but it meant that if I followed him, if I just let him lead the way, that moment to moment I'd have just what I needed to make it through to the next day. And that next day, he wouldn't leave me to be lost. I mean, he even wrote me this book. So that when I needed to know just how much he loved me and wanted to protect me so, I'd have some place to look. So it's him, the man from the story, the one from up above. He's the one. I need his love. He's the one. He protected me with his life. He's the one who looked at me with those eyes. Now I don't have this thing perfect, and sometimes I still look back and wonder why. But I've got this part down, and it's buried deep inside. Christ, he's the groom, and he sees me as his bride.